Hey guys, since you were asking about my NVIDIA settings, my monitor settings and my Overwatch settings, I wanted to make a quick guide on showing you how to get them the right way. Okay, after opening NVIDIA control panel, you want to go to manage 3D settings, and then you want to go into the program settings, not the global settings. Because the global settings are basically changing everything for all games, not just for one. And program settings, you can basically pick and choose which game you want to select, and then you can change the settings only for that specific game. You can basically copy everything that I have here, off, application controlled, off, ultra, off, auto select, prefer maximum performance, refresh rate highest available, because obviously you want to have the highest available that you have with your monitor, which mine is 240 hertz, texture filtering off, allow high performance, optimization off, triple buffering off, and vertex sync off. Basically, you can change these settings however you want to, but I would recommend just putting everything on maximum and highest performance because you want to get the maximum FPS out of your games. Okay, there is a small thing that I forgot to mention. You want to right click on your desktop and then go on display settings. From there, you want to go on advanced display settings and then display adapter properties for display one. Here you can choose between adapter, monitor and color management. You want to go on monitor. Here you can change the screen refresh rate. And when I bought the first time a 144 hertz monitor, I didn't change this. And I was like, I don't see any changes in my game. Like, I don't see any, improvement. And it seems like I forgot to change this first. So for the monitor settings, what you want to do is you want to press on the button on your monitor. Then you want to go on game settings. There you can go on black equalizer. I put that on 12. Color variance on 10. Low blue light on 0. Usually what I've heard is low blue light helps you with aiming and makes you like be more awake, but I feel like it's also like a big strain on the eyes. I'll put it off. Instant mode on and save settings, I have nothing there. Picture mode, you want to go on gamer 1. Brightness 55. Most of these are personal preference. You can change them the way you like. Contrast is 50. Sharpness is 7. Gamma 2. Color temperature, this one I put on user defined and put red, green and blue on 100. I feel like I can see the enemies better that way, at least for Overwatch. I'm a high, dynamic contrast 0, Samzai off, and reset color no. Usually you can use these settings for all games and mostly FPS games, but if you see like there are certain things that you don't like, just change them up the way you want. Okay guys, after doing everything that I told you already, changing the NVIDIA settings and the monitor settings, you want to go on Overwatch and then you want to change your settings in the video settings in options. You have display mode full screen because it is the one with the least input lag. Resolution 1920 to 1080, 240 hertz since I have a 240 hertz monitor. Field of view is usually 103. Reduce buffering on. I'm going to tell you guys a small tip with that one. Usually like on the FPS count on left corner, as you can see, there's one dot. If there's three dots, you want to change reduce buffering off and on. And that usually helps you with your GPU throttling. Seems like if you have three dots, your GPU is throttling, and if you have only one, everything is fine. Okay, the next thing you want to do is go to limit FPS and change it to custom, and then change it to the FPS that you get in a team fight. For example, if you get 300 in a training switch but only 150 in a team fight, you want to cap it at 150. That is because the input lag goes up and down, and you don't want to like get used to 300, and then when the teamfight starts, your FPS goes like to 250, then back to 150, and then back to 300, because that makes your aim less consistent. It's going to make it really hard to aim, and you want to keep it consistent. Graphics quality on low, everything else is low, 75% render scale. Usually the render scale at 100 gives you smaller outlinings, the red dot outlinings of the enemies, then 75, and 50 is just too blurry, that's why I keep it on 75. My anti-aliasing is low FXAA instead of off because I like the outlinings of the enemies. It just makes it like, I don't know, smoother. And shadow details, sometimes people do it low or medium or sometimes even high. I put it on off because sometimes what happens is the enemy is on high ground and you can see their shadow on the low ground. So if you don't see them on the high ground, you can sometimes understand that they're on the low ground because of the shadows. But I don't really use it too much. I don't really need it. That's why I keep it off. You can like change the settings however you want, but you want to usually get the maximum FPS out of your game because the more FPS you have, the less input lag, the easier it is to aim, and the easier it is to flick. My brightness is also a little bit off, like lower than usual than other people, because I like it that way. But I think that's about it. Okay, two small things that I didn't mention yet is you can go to your task manager, and then from there you want to go to details, then Overwatch X, and then set the priority to high. It ensures that your Overwatch X gets the most priority And from there, you get more FPS through that. Another thing is you want to go to your OWatch folder, and there on the OWatch launcher, you go to properties and then compatibility. And there you can disable full screen optimization. And that basically does the same thing. It gives you a little FPS boost. I tried it like both on and off, and I've seen that like I get more FPS on high and on disable full screen optimization. And I would recommend it. If you guys have any more questions left, just ask them in the comments. I have no friends, so I'm using a cookie box to hold my webcam while I'm recording this. Feels good, man, boys.